everybody. My name is Rita Varga. I come from also Hungary, but not from Budapest. You know, I come from Pécs. Pécs is a very nice historical city. This is in the south in Hungary, south part of Hungary, very close to the Croatian border. Not so close like you, 15 kilometers. But we have an interesting view because we have the same distance like Budapest and Zagreb and Ljubljana. So it looks like when we see the opportunity of the city, we have to make international cooperation. And then my association, which I we are present, this Approach Art Association, is always focused for the international networking. Okay, let's start. So the Approach Art Association was founded in 1995. Almost we are 20 years. We have 100 members, and the priorities is of course contemporary art programs, exhibition, professional protection in interest, networks, symposiums, art and culture events. We already ran two gallery, but at the moment we didn't running any gallery. We run only just the office and running an international exhibitions program. So our first gallery was the Approach Gallery. We started running in 1995 until 2010. And sorry, I forget to tell about my city information. In 2010, our city, Pécs, was the, also the capital of the European culture, like Košice. And it was a great opportunity for us, our city, because we had a very nice new infrastructure. For example, we had a very nice new concert hall, and we reconstructed also the Zsolnai Quarter, which is the old ceramics factory. And okay, you will see it why I speak about it. And from 2003, we already started running another gallery, Swan House Gallery, which is quite bigger, like the Approach Gallery. And we're running an atelier house for the local artists, but it was very short because we have to give back to the city. And from 2009, we're running an artist residency program. So we are non-profit. Most of the working or project from application. And we cooperate and we apply for the Center of Unemployed City for our employers. We have two active in my staff. And two EVS helpers and two volunteers. And we also got just some money from the National Culture Fund, but it was before from the Hungarian Fund. And most of the project that we are able to running, we run from the culture program, the European money, which is shows the networks, and also we running some of the program from by the Visegrad Fund. So it was our first gallery, Approach Gallery, which was 30 square meter big. It was a five Icelandic artist exhibition from Reykjavik. I enjoyed them very well, and how it looked like. The gallery when we start everything. It's like 30 square meter, like a home, whole place. And Swan House, it was a little bit bigger. It was 250 square meter big gallery. And we exhibited a lot of great artists, and we focus for the not only the Hungarian, but here we exhibited Hajnal Németh. She's a great Hungarian artist, and Ilona Németh also. And we not only organized a solo show, we also organized some shows which already ran, for example, in the Kunsthalle. Jozsef Kézman, the curator, organized this Plastika Dreams, which focused in the how it's running the Hungarian contemporary sculpture at that time. And we had a selection in our gallery. And we also chose the Intermedia Faculty of Intermedia Faculty from the Academy of Budapest, sorry. It was also very interesting and great show, and we cooperate with them, and they make a nice presentation for the city in outside also. And my favorite exhibition was the Wasteland, created by Bencsik Barnabás, Barnabás Bencsik. He was the director of the Ludwig Museum. And it was very important exhibition for us, because at that time, was before we became the capital of European culture, and the city was very excited about this event, about 2010. And the city sentence was, we are the gate of the Balkan. And if we are the gate of the Balkan, let's see what's happening in the Balkan. And we would like to invite and see that kind of artist who is really great in the Balkan, for example, Tobias Putri and Ivan Grubanov and David Malkovich. How we can use the places, because it was not enough. We run the gallery. And we always has a problem about running the gallery. So we run more than 10 years the gallery, and we have to pay a lot of money to renting cost for the local city, and we also has to found some funding money, how we can organize programs. We didn't get any money from the ministry, the Hungarian ministry. And this is just a temporary situation if we got money from the local government. And we always ask, we would like to push the local government, please give the places for free for the culture events, because this is not, we didn't agree about the civil society organized program. Organize the money from abroad or in other places, and the civil society who not make extra money has to pay a lot of money for the government also, and we don't agree and to pay any money for to renting cost. Because at the time we must rent like a business, running even not. So we have to pay a lot of money about the renting, and we had a problem about it, and we try to involve somehow, and we bring a different example how we can use different places. For example, we use the TV tour. We have a very nice TV tour in Pécs, because we have a nice mountains also. We organized together with our French partners Telenomad this multimedia performance. And we organized the performance parade also, and ETAT festival. And we have different networking programs, and which frame up the Culture 2000, the Culture 2007, and the European Capital of Culture. The first was the New Tendencies in Visual Arts between 2003 and 2004, which included the international, the Zoom International Video and Media Art Festival. We had a curator meeting in 2004 and the International Atelier Exchange Program, Marcia Biffin Pitch, local identification programs, which focus for the local artist in Pitch and the young artist, and we have the famous group Pitch Workshop, which they worked in the 1980s. They are five members. We organized the exhibition for them also, and we organized a huge festival of Media Factory. And this is very important for our life, for our association life in 2004, because we used the Joana Factory at that time. We were the first who used that part of the Joana Factory is the ceramic factory, and this is a quite huge, like 40,000 square meter huge factory, and just the more part at the time ran like a ceramic factory and another was totally empty. And thanks for the capital of culture situation, it became a new culture quarter, and the Faculty of Fine Art moved there, and the puppet theater and many cultural events, and we have a very great and nice gallery. Which is 1,000 square meter big, but I have also some photographs. Here you see the Media Factory that we organized. It was three created blocks. We used 3,000 square meter. It was a huge event. We invited 70 artists from 16 countries, and we can organize by the EU Culture Network program. We were the project leader, and you see our partners Burizon from Bratislava, Diaparidi from Maastricht, and Gallery Glamour from Reykjavik. And it was the Hungarian curated Andrea Bordac and Jozef Kiesman, and they represented the most important Hungarian artists. Here is some example, and the another was Tomek Wendland from Poland, who organized the Mediation Biennale in Poznan, and he created some international selection here. And we were the another curator, Attila and Attila Dobovitsky and me, and we also show some selection about our networking. And we organized some art communication and museum pedagogy program. And here is our next project, where we are not interested anymore the buildings, how we can use the buildings. In the project, we interested more how we can use the street, how we can use the cities, because we have the nice Király Street. This is the main street, but thanks for the globalization, of course, and like every city, when the supermarkets came in the city, the main city became empty, and the main road became also empty, and we have a lot of empty shops, and we thought how we can bring a new meaning of the city, not city, the street. We rent the empty shops and put some art events, and we invited our nice partners from abroad, but it was also kind of cooperation, Culture 2007 and 30 cooperation, and we can support the European Capital of Culture money. And our partner was the Dresden, the Montevideo, Amsterdam, and Inner Space Sofia. And you see, this is our gallery in the first floor in the Király Street. This is the main street. And we cooperate together with the architecture group. We have the very great and very important University of Pitch. We have, as I told, we have the Faculty of Fine Art, and we have a very great architecture department also. And we cooperate together with the architectures, and we build us nice stars, and we can able to direct to come in from the street. And it was a very great opportunity for us. It was temporary, of course, like all events. And why was important the temporarity at that time? It was also thanks for the capital of culture situation, because this is also just the temporary, and we always thinking what's will happening after 2010, how we running our gallery, how we running the civil sphere, how it look like, because okay, we got money from the local government at the moment, but what's will happening after 2011? We were scary about it. And we organized a lot of programming outside in the city. Many DJs was in doorway, DJs everywhere in the street. And we give different shops. For example, it was the Montevideo shops, and we had a very great selection of the super artists, like Yael Bartana is also. Was shown there. It was the Montevideo Amsterdam selection and his place, and it was the Lada project in Berlin, organized by Hoynal Németh, and it was the video space in Budapest. They also get the video space. This is a it was a great only one video gallery in Hungary, but it's still not exist anymore, running by Ekebe. And this it was another shops in and the Interspace. Petko Durman organized this interesting video installation, and it was kind of outdoor programs. And we also invited, we make the opportunity for the children. We had an application how they can the children also participate in the temporary city. We make an open call for the drawing programs, and the best drawings we painted on the kindergarten walls, and it was a nice project and cooperation with the children also. Our next festival was the In-Between Festival, curators curated by Ellen Ziegler and Christian Grandson. And it was focused that peripheric place of the city, which is not the city center. And the symbol of the In between was the red cube by Clara Oros, the location artist from Page. She reflected the red cube, and she made kind of installation on the street and in the different location in the city, in Uranienváros, in the Uranium City, which is the mining center, and the Garden City also. And the Ilona Németh exhibited this huge mirror, like 9 meters. It was our logo, the In-Between. This behind the Zsinagó. And oh, we have the best empty 25 levels building here, and which also participate, and this building also participated in the program. It was like a huge equalizer. We have the radio station, we have a private, not we have, but the city running the private radio, and at every evening 8 o'clock, start running, the radio start running list Franz Misa Solaris, and the building start to work like the equalizer. It was Carlo Crovato, and it was in the Garden City. Okay, I start to, yeah. We have these co-organizers partners. Telenoma, DMPLD, Saint-Étienne. So we had a lot from the Kosrak Center, Zsolnay Park, the Divus, Apartment Project, Istanbul, Bunkerszuki, Australia, Dresden, the last. Yeah. And we running our air program. We had more than 20 artists from abroad. And we cooperate together with the Apartment Project Istanbul, the Stromdenhig, and the Australia, and the Residence Unlimited from New York. And this is our residency artist. And we also sent some Hungarian artists to abroad. And every artist was kind of application. And this is was the demonstration that we had to give back to the to our gallery, the Swan House Gallery, to the city, because we had a problem about the financing. We stopped to run the gallery at that time, but now we're still running. And we organized the exhibition in Dunaújváros, in the Contemporary Art Center, how we can presenting themselves. At that time we demonstrated, we moved the city and moved to Dunaújváros. Yeah, like this. And we was the co-organizer of the Crazy Creators Biennale, which organized, and the project leader was the Space Gallery, and the curator Juraj Csányi and Katarina Slaninova. And we organized it in, it was the PH exhibition in the Vasvári Ház. And we running, and very important, of course, the visual education program in parallel. And let's, we are here, this is our last biggest project at the moment. This private nationalist project. This is an international cooperation, 7 exhibition, air exchange program between Dresden, the air exchange between Dresden, Istanbul and Pécs, and the International Museum Pedagogy Program, and the last conference. So it's still running. And we started in Prague in the last year in the Divus Gallery. And after the next one, will in Košice, was in Košice in the Kunsthalle, and in Hungary in Pécs. And so it is the cooperation between it come from the Visegrad Fund, because when the private nationalism, it mean about or same history or same dates, same historical dates. We have the same history. We have the same nations, the same mixed nations, and this program would like to focus how it's running. The nationalism. What does it mean? The nationalism here in the Central Europe. What's the difference between Central Europe and West Europe? And how it's looking in the different post-Soviet countries? How it's looking in the Yugoslav? It was only just a collection because everybody is working at this situation. So it is. I told about we exhibited in Pécs, and after the Dresden, it was the next exhibition, and we had a great show in Krakow in the last November, the Kalashnikov in the Bunkerszuki, and we have the last show by. Which was kind of off private nationalist exhibition and events. It was just now in Bratislava, created by Ilona Németh and Fedor Blaszák and Roko Juhász. And the next is, at the moment, we we don't see the future because this is a huge project. It's a huge project, you see, and but we had a problem about the financing because before we always running this Culture 2007 fund, but which cooperate together with the NKA, the Hungarian National Culture Fund, and the last year the NKA doesn't allow to sponsored the European programs for the civil sphere, and it's also brings a very hard situation for me, for the cooperation, and for my next partner, like the Turkish partner and the another Hungarian partner, because we are not at the moment. I have to find the financing for this part of the project, which is 20,000 euro. So I have to find somehow 20,000 euro until October. And or another Hungarian partner is also not exist anymore because the political situation, it is the MODEM. The MODEM is the first, it was the first biggest Hungarian contemporary art museum, which organized a great show in Debrecen, maybe you heard about it, and this is not exist anymore because they make a new structure and they involve together with the old local museum. And we don't know how it's still working, and we have to find also another partner. So I'm looking at that partners who would like to participate in this project, and but it's very, very, very strange. Yeah, but you can see the project because it was, this is the project. It was the first show in Prague. Sorry, the curators was Lenka Klodova and Iva Metzler. And it was in Košice. The curator was Ilona Nemeth, USN Jozef, and Mikhail Stofa. You see Kosha boys, so, the Hungarian Socialist Reality and the Little Warsaw's work. And Dan Perizhovsky, we have a very nice artist there, and nice events also. And we had also the problems with the Czechoslovakian flags, which is also shows us how it's working, the problems between Slovak and Slovak and the Czech ministry, because we know, so we it was the Czech, before it was the Dalibor Bača exhibited the Czechoslovakian flags in Košice, and the Czech minority of Košice I don't know in English. Make not a void, the negative void about this project. And my partners, Kosak Institute, not allow them self-financing. They deleted, the Ministry of Slovakia deleted the self-financing of the Slovakian part of the project. So it's also make a terrible situation. But you see Richard Wiesner, the Czech artist, also made the same flag situation on the floor, because the Czech association has the problem about the flags on the floor. But they didn't see the exhibition, they just see across the door situation, and they didn't come to the exhibition. And it became many bad and hard situation to the Kossak Center, to Rocco, because they deleted the last year, they didn't get any money from the Slovakian ministry, and they became the huge nationalism Slovak artist, Ilona Németh, and USR Jozsa became the national Slovakian artist, the biggest national Slovakian artist like this. And it was in the private nationalist show in Pécs. In the beginning was the Kassa Boys, my favorite works from them, and also the Little Warsaw's works. And this is the gallery in the Zsolnay factory, which is 1,000 square meter big gallery. And it, and you can see also András Csifavai works and Martin Piacek's. So we had also 17 countries, almost 60 artists. And we use not only the gallery, we use our Swan House gallery, and it was the Sandra Colli exhibition, not exhibition, it was kind of reflection about what's happening in Budapest at that time, because at that time in Budapest it became a new monument, which is a really terrible German Green Monument, and it started, oh, it's hard to speak about it. It's founded a smart group, the Smart Monument, the living who demonstrated about this German monument. This, oh, it's hard to speak, sorry. And this is our visual communication programs also, and we are making kind of open history programs also. And this is the exhibition in Dresden, in the Australe, which is the huge festival, and curator is Nadine Bosch and Andrea Hilger. Yeah. And this is the last exhibition we had in Krakow, the Kalashnikov in the Bunkerstuki, and the curator was Anna Liebenstein and Lydia Kravchik. This is the Nikita Kadan's work and Tomas Kulka's work. And every exhibition was another choice and another meaning also, and another curator approaching. Yeah, and that's it. Thanks.